Good morning, everyone. Okay. My microphone is on. So, siloed efforts looking into extended reality as a clinical tool. And today, I want to help you see that walking that road less traveled does not necessarily mean walking alone. So, how did I find myself at the intersection of a road less traveled? In 2017, I started working on a post-surgical ward for the VA as a brand new registered nurse and noticed pretty quickly that I really didn't have a whole lot available to offer for pain and anxiety management. And I was like, well, there must be a better way. So I did some searching, and long story short, I ended up trialing first use of extended reality, virtual reality in this capacity, as a positive distraction for pain and anxiety in 2018. So that project has now since grown a lot to other patient areas, to other use cases, to other VAs. Not only was this my road less traveled, but it actually became a new path for veterans as well. And I could talk for hours about veteran response and experience with virtual reality, and I can tell you I often do. But today I'll just tell you one of my favorite stories. So a wheelchair-bound Army veteran with chronic pain and cognitive impairment was often restless, agitated, frustrated. I'm sure she felt like she was on a road less traveled. It was certainly unfamiliar to her. She was a resident in our long-term care facility, and one day we introduced her to virtual reality. So now I want you to imagine, and we've heard that word a lot in the past couple of days, a wheelchair-bound Army veteran who feels trapped by her immobility and confusion now getting to walk through the woods again, climb rocks, wade through wildflowers, walk along a beach. This patient was beyond excited. Her face became a smile. She couldn't stop turning around in her chair trying to see more and more of this virtual environment. And then she invited us to join her on her road. She let us know that she used to volunteer at the local nature center before becoming immobile. So virtual reality as a clinical tool improved this patient's quality of life, even if only temporarily, by transporting her to a world where the road less traveled was a little less alone. Now, it's important to note that in the development of this innovative program, throughout this process of proposing and piloting and spreading, there was some work. I've had successes and failures, but I also ended up with a really strong support system. So I was on that road less traveled, but it didn't mean I had to do it alone. And this strong support allowed me to offer support to our veterans. That's a win-win situation. So how did I find that support as a bedside nurse? Gratefully, we have a strong culture of innovation and nursing shared governance at the Asheville VA. I was initially supported by my nurse manager, by one of our nurse educators, to actually pursue this idea as my project for the RN Transition to Practice program. And then after presenting to one of our shared governance councils, I was then supported by one of our clinical nurse specialists. And then after presenting to our Nurse Executive Council, I was supported by our Chief Nurse of Acute Care and our Chief Nurse Executive. So you can already tell that I was not alone in this path. It really was dependent on me identifying and gradually pulling in all of the people that could help me take that path. And after initial approvals by Nursing Service and an initial pilot in 2018, I had some really great data showing impact. So now, with the support of our, at the time, innovation specialist, the infamous Dr. Ann Bailey, I applied to Spark Seed Spread. And I applied to Shark Tank that year. And I was denied by both of them. However, that did not stop me, and an initial no should not stop you either. I believed in the power of what I developed and its positive impact on our veterans and the clinicians caring for them. So through the support system I had built locally, I was supported to apply for the American Nurses Credentialing Center Pathway Award, and got it. $25,000 to spread the project to our community living center and to our other inpatient areas, my support system had now widened to the leaders of the ANCC. And I didn't stop there. I applied for Spark Seed Spread again in 2019, this time as a Spread investee, and got it. I became a fiscal year 20 investee for Spark Seed Spread. So now I also had the support of the VHA Innovators Network and the Innovation Ecosystem. Now, that's not the end of my road less traveled, as many of you know, but I really want to zoom back out again to some points that I really want you to take away from this. Sometimes the freshest eyes see the most clearly. And there is no doubt that our employees actually doing the work definitely do. I was a brand new registered nurse and a brand new VA employee, but I saw a problem and I knew that there must be a better way. Now, did I doubt my ability to impact as a newbie? Absolutely. I thought, there's no way I have the experience to make big changes. But I'm here to tell you that that is just not true. It's not just about experience. It's about awareness. It's about empathy. It's about determination to make things better. So whether you're a new employee or an OG of the VA, the ability to see what could be better and imagine what could be created is yours. It's your voice that needs to be heard. This story is also about finding that support system. So whether that is a colleague, your innovation specialist, your supervisor, leadership, there is someone in this giant organization that is going to support you in developing and investigating and testing your ideas. And if you can't find anyone still, I promise I will help you. You can just email me. I'll put it up here at the end. So if you see a problem and you can't find something better, create it. If you have a wild idea and you want to see if there's something to it, let us know. No one should feel like they have to go this alone, because this is really a team endeavor and not a solo path. So I call upon all of you to open yourselves to the support of others. Now, I have always been an independent force to be reckoned with. I do not like to ask for help. My parents will totally back me up on that concept. But I can tell you from experience that not only does it feel good to find your support system, but it also will contribute to your success in making true impact. So as I've been on this journey from new nurse to VA XR guru, I have also been on a path to become the support system. I want to join others as they travel down their roads less traveled. So what started as one project and one VA has now become a giant network of forward-thinking employees that are ready to discover and implement new tools to improve their work in veteran care. We've seen the community of support that has now become the VHA XR network go from only 10 members in 2019 to 37 in 2020. To 240 in 2021, and now over 1,200 VA employees in 2022. So for anyone that is interested in utilizing immersive technology for veterans, for caregivers, for employees, the XR network is here to make sure that you have your support system. So we are here for you. We want you to feel like you're as supported as I was, even if we're hundreds of miles away. So if you need an SOP, we got you. You need a CPRS template, we got a lot of those too. You want to collaborate with some external folks, let's make it happen. Confused by VA processes about buying and utilizing new technology? We are too, often. But we will walk that path together and we will figure it out. So extended reality use in VA facilities went from just those few sites 5 years ago to now, with the help of the XR network, we have XR technology in every VISN, every state, even Puerto Rico, over 20 use cases across the VHA. We've seen this rapid growth because employees are helping employees. Communication is open. Ideas are flowing. We are walking this new road together and supporting each other along the way. I can tell you we did not get to where we are by saying no. As we like to say in innovation, this is a yes and kind of adventure that we hope you'll join us on. Because I hear employees say all of the time, the VA has that, or the VA does that, or I can be a part of this. And I say, yes, you can. And to top it off, the VA wants you to. And lastly, the most important thing about innovating in the VA is, of course, our veterans and how it impacts them. And I have veterans that say to me with disbelief, the VA does that? I didn't know they offered things like that. And I say, yes, we do. And we hope to do so much more. So everyone, let's find those roads less traveled, then walk that way together to create the future of VA healthcare. Thank you.